Guys, what's going on? This is Brad from SCFC for Live Gaming, and this is episode number 2 of our career with Crystal Palace. Last episode did go down pretty decently, to say so at the least, but it wasn't that good. It was a good episode, apart from the two injuries we did get in Berg and Patrick Bamford. So now we're just going to be sorting out a team where we do have our first away game. It is going to be against Arsenal at the Emirates. It's going to be a hard game. To start off our season, it is going to be a game we're going to have to try and tear by the scruff of the neck. Hopefully we can get 3 points out of it. But as you can see now, just sorting out the team, just looking at which players can be good enough to maybe go into the team or just have a place on the bench. I think we do need to put Shola Amiobi somewhere on this bench. I don't like this player, but he will. He's sort of one of them Bobby Zamora players, isn't he, in getting positions to get the goals. So yeah, this is the team. We're going to start Julian Speroni in goal, Joel Rod right back, Damien Delaney and Breda Hangeland centre back, Aki left back, Jedinak, Ledley and Will Hughes in the three in the middle, Zaha on the right, Balassi on the left and Glenn Murray down the middle. And this is going to be a very hard game. It's going to be difficult because we are playing Arsenal. Obviously, they're going to want to get off to the best start they can obviously get. They're going to want 3 points. Obviously, Sanchez is going to be making a debut. Obviously, Giroud is obviously going to be up there somewhere up front. But hopefully, Breda Hangeland can sort him out.
Let's look at the draw of the English League.
So, in our office now, we have a match rescheduled. Abia is wanting to have an involvement, but unfortunately we cannot give him any involvement along the lines. We are going to have to wear our very nice yellow kit. So hopefully we can get 3 points out of this. There will be maybe 3 games played per episode, maybe 4, depending how we feel. I know 2 of them are away, 1 at Emirates, 1 at St. James's Park and 1 at Selhurst Park. If you're not sure on the stadiums, we do play Arsenal, and then we do, I can't remember, who do we play in the middle of this? It's West Ham at home, at the Selhurst Park, and then obviously we play Newcastle. My team, I do support and real life rivals. Hopefully we can get 3 points from there, since they seem to be dishing out quite well in real life. So the commentary for this game is Martin Tyler and Alan Smith. So yeah, now let's have a look into the lineups, starting with Arsenal's. There you can see Hughes making his debut. Nathan Aki's also making a debut, and hopefully Glenn Murray will have a good return. So, can we get into the Arsenal lineup a bit quicker? So here is the Arsenal lineup: Szczesny in goal. They've got Cavani making a debut, Debuchy, Koscielny, Gabriel, Monreal, Wilshere, Ramsey, Rositsky, Sanchez. That's going to be a solid midfield. Cavani and Welbeck, and Giroud drops to the bench. So does Cazorla, Ozil and Walcott. But there's our Crystal Palace fans hoping for a good game. There's our team: Speroni in goal, Ward, Delaney, Hangeland and Aki made the defence. Hughes, Jedinak and Ledley, and then the front three: Zaha, Murray, Balassi, Hennessy, Suarez, Dan, Kelly, MacArthur, Amiobi and Fraser Campbell all on the bench there. If you want to pause, make sure you pause, get a good look at the players. But Arsenal have just had an FA Community Cup match against Manchester City. I don't know how they done. They might have lost, they might have won, but anyway, they could have some pretty tired players. But Sanchez making a debut alongside Edison Cavani. But here we go, our first kickoff.
Yes, those first 15 minutes or so were
a bit of a
weird
pass.
To say the least, for anybody connected,
we do play on professional for anyone just tuning in.
That's a terrible pass, come on, Balassi. So you just hope it can be the start of better things to come.
Oh, Jedinak.
Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it.
I think Champions in the squad, so I think they might have won the cup.
Here comes the cross.
Good ball if Glenn Murray was tackling or challenging that a little bit earlier.
Now Damien Delaney. Well, he's
Played it into the wide area. That's good. That's good. The block there by Sanchez.
In the way there, and he's deflected the ball out of play.
Oh, Aki making a debut for 775k. You can't go wrong there. With a very talented left back. Oh, he's offside. I thought he drifted back, was drifting back a bit quicker than he actually was. So he did give away a free kick there for being offside. Oh, they're just going to get to him, aren't they? Delaney, that's a good ball. Zaha, have a shot. That's good defending. Murray.
He will be adjudged offside here. Close.
Oh, was it Murray offside? Another offside, that's pretty embarrassing. Come on, Palace. 3 points, please.
Sanchez.
Oh, he's Sanchez. I think if he gets into our area, if he gets past Damien Delaney, but that's a good title by Hughes on his debut. That's a good ball. Go on, Murray. Oh, he's offside again.
70 minutes played. 1-0.
Come on, Glenn.
Thank you very much, Alan.
He's going to have to beat him for quite a while, at least 6 weeks, due to the injury of Marcus Berg.
Aaron Ramsey. There's some potential in this move. Rosicki.
Oh, no, actually, he'll only have 4 weeks left since he missed the two friendlies. So he'll be back soon, before you know it. Maybe ready for the next episode for his debut. Come on, Niall Jedinak. Oh, is Bolasie not going to make that run?
Do you have any regrets, Alan, that the injury that finished your career means you can never play on this lovely pitch at the Emirates Stadium, even in a charity match at the end of the season?
What a tackle.
It would have been nice, but of course, there was nothing like Highbury. I think they all kind of missed.
Oh, good tackle.
Football ground, but
come on, Ward. I think he's more of a left back, but we have tried him out right. Zaha. I keep thinking that's Damien Delaney.
That's
good footwork. Come on, Zaha.
Life goes on, Alan.
Life does go on.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Decision by the football club,
good tracking back.
Maybe they'll get a replacement in quickly. Joe Ledley.
Well, I've got a finish mid-table. I think if we play well, we get the good points. Our players have a good attitude towards the team. We could get 8th or even higher. Come on, Murray. Oh, Murray. He done the hard work there by taking the ball down, but there was nothing he could do to get the vital touch. Delaney with a great header. Come on, Zaha. That's a good cross, Bolasie.
Attack has fizzled out here. Goal kick.
He was so close to beating him about there.
EA Sports quick. Jog of your memory.
He was like really, really close from beating I think it was Debuchy.
Really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
Oh god! Go on, Aki. That's a great, good challenge, and that's a poor pass there by Welbeck. Look at that space opened up there for Ledley. Ledley. Oh, he's missed. We have got a corner, but watch Wilfred Zaha. Watch Wilfred Zaha here. He flicks it. He hits it down. It goes up, hits the bar, comes out. Zaha goes to bicycle kick it and completely misses the ball. Nathan Aki. That would have been a decent low shot. Maybe he could have beaten them.
Really.
Good keeper there.
Raider Hangerland. His debut for the club, a good signing.
I think so.
Oh, that's good footwork. Come on.
Showed some form at his old club.
Oh, scoop.
It's all about transforming that to him.
That's a great cross.
That cross is cleared by the defender.
Hughes, you've given away a free kick. You can't be going spearing into people like that.
We know this team does this all the time. Try and catch the opposition out with this quick free kick.
Oh, it's a good block.
Climbed well to head it to the supporting player.
Go on, Hughes. That's a good half. I'll take it. 0-0 away from home against Arsenal. But I think it's going to time to be in it. I know. We're going to try Shola Amiobi on his debut for Glenn Murray. Hopefully, he can be a bit more veteran-like and get a goal. So and we're also going to change, take off Nathan Aki, swap him with Joel Ward, and that is the lineup. So there's the lineup. Pause if you want to look. The only changes was we took off Aki for Kelly and then swapped the left back and right back, and we took off our striker for Shola Amiobi. Just to see how he'll adapt to life at a new club.
Coming up at the Emirates. Attacking well here. Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free.
Oh, good tackle. Delaney being a rock out the back. That's a good block as well.
It's Ward. Michael Oliver, the referee, has stopped the play.
Oh, Bolasie.
What about Crystal Palace and their next game, Alan?
Yeah, they're playing West Ham United in their next match.
Yeah, confirmation of that game's just been said there. If you didn't hear, you did see we have Crystal Palace next. I mean, West Ham next. Crystal Palace have West Ham. And I think Arsenal have Everton. Oh, that's a great cross as well. And Cavani's cross is into Welbeck, and he beats Martin Kelly. That is, look at the defending there. That's a great cross as well. Nothing Spironi could do about that. Nothing Hangalan could do about that. But Martin Kelly should have done a bit better. That's a cross. That is. He's came on and he hasn't really made much of an impact yet, Martin Kelly. Of everything he's made a bad
Joe Ledley.
Come on. Here's Amiobi. Look at that space. Ledley! I was right in front of the Palace fans, I think. Yes, it was. Oh, we could have got a goal there. Go on, Shola. Has he even played for Palace yet? Like, on real life.
Some activity down on the Arsenal bench.
Oh, it's nutmeg.
Well, this is great team. Referee's pointing.
Why are we diving into these stupid tackles? And Cazorla makes his introduction here.
And it's clearly a tactical one to try and cement that winning position.
So that would have been a good time to win the ball. And a long shot straight over the bar of Julian Spironi.
It's going to be a substitution for Arsenal.
Oh, Debussy. It's unlucky. Oh. Lassie. Amiobi. Shola Amiobi's got a debut goal against Arsenal. I know it was a sweaty goal, but there we go, guys. Come on. Our first goal. That's a great pass as well. Great work there by Yannick Bolasie to win the ball back. There we go. He's made an impact already, has Shola Amiobi. And I don't really like Amiobi after what he has recently, well, not recently, what he did do sometimes against Sunderland. But that's pass now. Zaha. Look at that's great ball. Can Bolasie keep that in? He can. Come on, boys. We have been the much better team this past turn. It's a great cross as well. Amiobi. Does chuck himself around in the box a little bit, does Amiobi, to try and win the ball. Oh, Delaney. He's coming really close forward. Out. Oh, not back to him. That's a great tackle, Jedinak. Shame about the pass, though. Oh, what a ball. Out with Bolasie. Ledley. Go on, Ledley. Oh. Put over. Go on, Amiobi, please. Take this down.
Everton after this.
3 points here would be great. A great start. Would give us a bit of a top gear here. bit of a win, lose, or draw parameter against West Ham. Good clearance. Ami will be. Oh, he's brought that down nicely. Come on, Bolasie.
Many thanks, Jeff.
Bit of work here by the new five-star skiller. Bolasie. Zaha! That is a great save by Wojciech Szczęsny. Bolasie. That's a good ball. Ami Obi! Oh my god. Hughes head that back into the area. Ami Obi, someone! I'm not. One-one draw is pretty good. We did. Well, so far, we have got a point at the Emirates against Arsenal.
His penalty was saved, of course, in the shootout.
And as the centre came in. And that, there we go. Full time. Shame that touch there at the end by Ami Obi. Couldn't go into any use. But there, 1-1. It's pretty decent. We're just going to get straight into the next game against West Ham at home. Our first home game. The Barclays Premier League. So I think it's Arsenal pretty much going to be the same team, apart from McCarthy is going to come in. Dan's going to get him come Chelsea on for Delaney. We're going to give Suarez the game, and we're going to start the goal scorer, Shola. He's also going to start against Newcastle as well, because I would love to see a Newcastle legend. Wait, what? Wait, what people think is a Newcastle legend score past them? Now I'm just looking to see if we do have any sort of budget allocations, which we don't have. But here we go. This is the table so far. West Brom are at the top. Chelsea are second. Hull are third. Leicester fourth. Man City are fifth. Burnley, Sunderland and Newcastle are now so far in the bottom three. That's only after one game, so that could change after our second. West Ham, I think they did get a draw in their first game as well. So here we go, our first home game.
What comes next in the
they can wear that. So there's the team. Spironi still in goal. Ward, Suarez, Hangland and Scott Dan. Jedinak, MacArthur and Ledley. Bolasie, Shola Miobi and Wilfred Zaha is our lineup. Entertain sixth placed Stoke City. Come on. I wish you could have an option to turn these skill games off. I actually hate them. They just sort of spoil, like, the content. If you can't just get straight into the game. Right, so here we go. First game at Selhurst Park. It is going to be against West Ham. It's going to be a hard game. Another hard game. Let's head straight for Selhurst Park then, right now. Perfect conditions at the home of Crystal Palace with clear blue skies in London. Here's your commentary team, Martin Tyler. Hopefully we can give these fans something to cheer about. Just letting the light cinema, I think, going now. There's Yannick Bolasie. Hopefully he can make a bigger impact than he has had. After their last game, which was away, and they drew against Arsenal. Come on, boys.
Yeah, positive to take from the 1-1.
That's a great win already.
I do fancy them for victory.
Mile Jedinak wins the ball straight from their kickoff and has on the attack. But we don't have a winger yet up here.
Here comes the cross.
Zaha. Ami Obi should have challenged that a bit more than he did there. It's been an electronic start so far. It's all been us. Oh, that's a poor ball. And Cresswell clears it while he was under pressure.
James MacArthur.
I don't like going down the line. That's great footwork by Zaha. And Jednak clears, and here comes Stuart Downing. With Hangland. Jedinak! That's a great save. Great shot as well there by our captain, Niall Jedinak. They haven't actually got into our half yet.
Morgan Amalfitano. Downing.
This should be. This is going to be. We're going to win. We are going to win this game. You can tell by the style of play that they're playing. They haven't even got out their half yet.
Downing. Didn't hesitate, did he? With
that shot. Hey, they finally got past the halfway line.
Manager
and they pass it straight out. So we're just going to leave where West Ham play as poor as they are. It should be a bit better since we do play on professional. Ooh, that is a mistake there. And the interception is made. Oh, but Scott Dan. That's a good tackle, Jedinak. Come on. Oh, great work. That's why he's our captain. Niall Jedinak doing a very very well. Here they are on the attack. Great tackle, Dan. And again. Come on, Ledley. Oh, Ledley, that's a foul. Should have given us the advantage there because I could have played through. Oh, there's Zaha. It's Jessica Linen actually in goal. Ah, that was bad. Shouldn't have played that.
In their next match in the Barclays Premier League, it could be a backs to the wall match for them.
Valencia. Come on.
Joe Ledley.
Ledley. Balassi sort of made a good run there. Balassi.
Best connection, was it?
You've got to be a screamer. New footballs right in the middle, right on that sweet spot.
Yeah, and he's normally quite reliable when it comes to striking the ball, but got that one a little bit wrong.
Right, come on, Ledley. He's playing very very well. We have actually sort of played him in more of a cam role.
Valencia.
Come on. It's a great tackle, Dan. Oh, he's crossed. Well, this could be dangerous here. And that's a poor shot. After all that pressure we did put on in maybe the first 15 minutes, they have sort of came more out of their half.
Yannick Bolasie.
The pressure does, but here's Bolasie.
It's looking good, this move.
It's a good one. Oh. He breaks the ankles there of Winston Reid, and wins a corner, which he will go short to him. Oh, it's a poor cross. Oh, that's a poor. Zaha, what a goal! What a goal! Debut goal, home debut goal there by Wilfred Zaha. From the corner we played short. Bad defending by Winston Reid, I think it was. He let it roll through his legs, then Zaha tackled him. And then he finessed it into the corner. That's a great goal by Zaha for his first since signing from Manchester United. This could be a big win.
Now Song.
Ledley. Zaha.
The added time is
four. Oh, good. Good skill move there by Zaha. And again.
Here comes the cross.
Amiobi. What a save. Bolasie. That was a good save there by Jack Grant. He's made a few of them. Ah. Down and. Come on, square it. That's good, boy. There we go, 1-0 up at half time. The team's going to stay the same. It's playing very well.
So we're all set for the second half.
Hopefully, oh. That trick didn't work.
It's a second goal for Chelsea. It's been scored by Oscar.
It's a good ball as well. He's Scott Dan.
Lovely swerving effort from the edge of the area that tickled the post. Oh, God.
47 minutes
played.
Come on, Ledley.
Cheers, Alan.
Good cut there. Come on, Abiobi. Oh, what a title. That's Kiyati, isn't it?
He's being challenged now.
Oh, sorry. He's been caught out loads there. Look at the gap he's left as well for Amalfitano to run into.
Gets
across.
Well defended here from a good cross. It's one back.
Come on.
That's a good challenge.
Oh. It's been all West Ham so far.
That's very
till Jedinak gets the ball. Come on, Amiobi. Balassi out here somewhere. Yes, he is. That's a good ball. Come on, Balassi. Stay on the edge, stay on the edge.
In with a chance. Pushed back into play by the goalkeeper.
Right, Ward. Oh, come on, Ward. Here's Valencia.
Jarvis.
Oh, wow. That's a great block. Puts it out for a West Ham corner. Now they've got their chance for a set piece. They take off Chiari and put on Mark Noble. Oh, Dan, he's trying to look for a nutmeg there. But Zaha, the goal scorer, can come out of the ball here. It's good footwork and Jednak. Balassi. Another finesse. Jedinak! Off the bar. Good shot, good save. And then a header by Jedinak to follow up the shot by Zaha. I mean by Balassi, sorry. Off, rattled the bar.
It's a second goal for Swansea City. It's been scored by Bifetimbi Gomez. He was in the right place at the right time to guide the ball home. 70 minutes played. 2-0.
Zaha.
Oh, he's through.
With the goalkeeper. 2-0. Wilfred Zaha again at Rotten Sadhouse Park on his home debut for the club, playing very, very well this game. Look at the defending, it's absolutely terrible. Cresswell moves up, you can see him moving up, and then Ledley finds that ball first time through Balassi. 1-on-1, obviously going to make it 2-0, isn't he? And wraps it round Jussi Jaskalainen. We've absolutely murdered these. And that's a great tackle as well by Jednak, who was unlucky to score there.
Just over a quarter an hour left on my watch.
Balassi was also unlucky to score. Quite easily passed Guy Demel. That's a great ball. Jednak. Talk. Sort it out, man. One of them should have took the ball. Lead off the other one. And Demel beats it out under pressure. So there's 10 minutes left. They take off Stuart Downing. Ledley, go on. Good cross as well. And Song trying to travel the tackle by Jednak. Come on. Goes down and get a third goal here.
Morgan Amalfitano.
Malfitano.
They should win now, shouldn't they? 2-0 here, not much time to go. What impact will that have?
Oh,
on the
what
next
a tackle.
Well, West Ham United go up against Southampton.
Go on, Amiobi.
After this, and really don't think they'll be happy at all. The manager, in fact, I think he's furious with them. Substitution now for West Ham
McCarthy.
United.
Shola Amiobi. That's a good ball, Amiobi.
Chance for it.
Amiobi. He's got 2-2 now, has Amiobi. We can't take him off the team yet. He's scoring goals. He had to work quite hard there after the pass on the tackle, where the clearance, it was a clear lining. Headed by MacArthur. Amiobi runs, nearly loses it, but then he chops back and then smacks it for his second goal in two games at Palace. He is going to play against his former club Newcastle, which will be the third and final game of this episode. 2 minutes of added time. Come on, let's give Sputmoney a clean sheet. There we go. 3-0 win. Amiobi and Zaha getting two. Zaha getting man the match. The team's going to stay exactly the same. In our away trip against Newcastle.
The Barclays Premier League. Aston Villa 2, Newcastle United 1.
So, moving on, MacArthur sparkles on debut. He was pretty good.
What comes next in the English Premier League? The league leaders, Chelsea, entertain.
We should be quite high up in the league now. After that win. because I could have changed everything around, really. So, look at that. We've got two games against Newcastle. We've got them away in the cup, and then we've got them away again. Next episode. So, first game next episode is going to be against Newcastle. And there we go. Look who's back from injury. Marcus Berg. We are going to take Murray off the bench and put Berg on. He will probably make an appearance against our next game. But we have two games against Newcastle. One this episode, one next. And I think the league will be more important than a cup. A Capital One cup. We don't have to do good in that. Come on, Ariobi. Imagine if you got like a hat trick or something. Here we are against Newcastle. Teams, I'm just going to let the teams run across the bottom so we can get straight into the game.
Newcastle United, three changes. Tim Krul starts in goal. Stephen Taylor replaces Paul Dummett, who's been out of sorts lately. Jake Tiote starts, looking to recover his form. In attack, Trapis Cisse starts. He has been out of sorts lately. Here's the Crystal Palace.
It's a good start, actually, by Newcastle here. Tackled by Suarez. This is a great start by Newcastle. Wasn't expecting that. He's Ledley. Oh, he sold Williamson. Attacking Myanmar. Oh, shame Bolasie can't beat Dutchman. Dal Janmaat. Is that Federico Ferreira? Hangland.
Joe Ledley.
Go on, Amiobi. And that's a penalty. Mike Williamson. Pulling on the shirt of Amiobi. Brings him down. Yellow card, Williamson, and a penalty to Palace, which Niall Jedinak is going to step over and take. Hopefully he can score and put us 1-0 up away from home. Jedinak fires it over Tim Krul and gets our goal.
Just decided to use power. Northern placement, and he did the job.
Great penalty.
And here's the goal again.
The penalty was rightly given there by the referee. I think it is Mike Dean. Not sure. Listen how quiet it's gone.
Crystal Palace, they're playing well at the moment. They certainly played well last
That's
time
a great
out
tackle.
In their home victory.
Jedinak is one of my favourite. He's been one of my favourite players so far in this career. It's a great penalty as well. He knew what he was doing. Damn, great header. Ooh, that could have been one of them shots where your keeper. Keep it, didn't even try and save. Come on, Joel Ward. Might have been a crunching tackle there.
Maurizio Colaccini, the home manager's got to just delve into his resources, his reserves to cover.
He's Cabela. That's a great tackle.
Yeah, and he's a leader out on the pitch normally.
Keep him in this corner.
His voice and his leadership qualities.
Haidara loses to Bolasie. Come on, Bolasie. Go and get straight up that line. That's really hurt my eyes, that pattern there. Ah, Williamson.
He got the ball, the defender, in the wide position. Yannick Bolasie.
Oh, great work by Bolasie in the Amiobi. Oh! That was a great low header. If that went into the bottom corner past Team Cool. How do you do the celebration where you just put your hands up?
Keeps it going. He's gone for goal.
Ooh. Pappy Cissé.
Well, the striker's getting a bit of stick off his own fans, and
he's actually one leg. He's a good player, but the only thing which I don't like about him is the way he chucks himself around, and some of the actions he does to other players is just absolutely disgusting. Mate, we spat at Johnny Evans. Go on. That was still in. That was still in. Come on, MacArthur. Come on.
Newcastle United, people might forget, finished in the top half of the table in 2013-14.
Oh, what a cross.
Didn't seem like that, did it?
Well, out. It didn't, mate. There always seems to be a soap opera going on.
Oh, look at that defending there. Thank God Tiotti didn't get a decent enough shot there. If he did, that'd have been a goal. If he got his best shot, one of his shots, which are actually very good. Big boot. Go on, Schürrle. Come on. Go on, Amiobi. Right, so we're nearly at the half-time break. Could be another lead here.
Well, the attacker
doing pretty well.
Spoiled for choice, really, in terms of
Jan Maas.
Good work from the defender.
Go.
Then, who was really challenged by the quality of the ball that he had to deal
Go.
With.
Look at that run. Go, Balassi. Go, go. Keep his, what's the keeper doing? Amiobi! I'm actually enjoying Amiobi as well. I know it's on shooting. I'm probably going to get criticised by Sunderland fans, but he is actually pretty good on FIFA.
Joe Ledley.
Come on, Balassi.
Yannick Balassi.
Let's try and put the 3 points out of distance before this half's over.
Well. Maybe the cross.
It's a great cross. Amiobi! And he scores against his former team. The team he was at for very, very long. After the shot he just missed there. And I said, try and get these points out of drift for Newcastle. It's a great cross by Balassi. And it's a great header by Amiobi. Swerves it past. Swerves straight past Tim Krul for his third goal. But that's going to be his last action of this half. Because what does he say at the beginning of the episode? Marcus Berg is one of our strikers who we do have on the bench.
Half time now, and 2-0 is the
Can you listen to the boos?
Well, here we are at half time, and it's a bit of a stunned atmosphere.
And I know he's done very well, but Marcus Berg is still yet to make his debut. He was pretty much one of our most expensive signings. So yeah, we did decide to swap him for Schürrle Amiobi, and here he is straight away. And he's just been absolutely snapped already.
It's a very crisp challenge there. Shake Tiote.
Right, come on.
Trying to find an opening. Not panicking.
Go on, Schürrle. Oh, Balassi. He's tackled Dalian, that.
On EA Sports, coming soon, the English League Cup fixture. Crystal Palace.
Look, I think is it in 3 days or 4 days time after this game? Might even be shorter. That's a great save. We play Newcastle. It's going to be a weaker team. It's obviously going to be a bit of a weaker team. But yeah, guys, for people who are just joining, this is going to be the last game of the episode. You haven't missed out on a pretty good episode. Come on, Berg. Oh, he's been tackled. There's Jan Maas.
Remy Kabala.
Who doesn't Jedinak just absolutely murder? He's absolutely, he's very, very good. And there's Joel Ward trying to do his defending. Here's Jan Maas. He's been very decent getting these deliveries in. And that's a good one. Great defending there by Suarez, just to let the ball overrun, and that's a great flick by Balassi. Come on, Balassi. He can probably go all the way. He's much quicker than Williamson.
Playing Crystal Palace in the next match in the Capital One Cup.
That's another penalty, and it's been given. It's another stupid tackle by another Newcastle player. This is what they do. This is why. This is why they're bottom of the league in our division on career mode. And, yeah, let's not talk about that. But we are going to give it to this man, Marcus Berg, brand new Magistas. As you can see, that orange Magistas. Hopefully, he can put this penalty past Tim Crewell. Debut goal. We did decide to substitute him off. Substitute him on, sorry, for sure, Amiobi. After Amiobi did get his goal, which I did try pretty hard to get. Look at the Newcastle fans there. But Marcus Berg, after his pretty crucial, bad injury he had, which kept him off for 6 to 7 weeks, to come back. Pretty damn good tracking there, getting into the box for that run by Bolasie. And there he is, just to put that penalty straight into the top left corner past Tim Crewell.
It looks like the opposition is in for an aerial bombardment here. Judging by the way the centre
half. Oh, they've pulled one back. That's terrible defending. I was actually trying to take Yamat down when he passed the ball there. But then Musa Sissoko gets his first goal. But let's not give them any hope. You know what they're like when they get one goal. Come on, let's just but we're not just going to be like that and just keep it. We are going to try and just go back onto another attack. It's a good ball as well. Their defender's just done exactly what I was doing. Ooh, Berg. You should have tried. Should have tried a bicycle kick there.
Yannick Bolasie.
Oh, great footwork. Beats Teodi. Back to Marcus Berg. That's a good clearance. And damn, what a header. Is that Stephen Taylor? Is it? Yeah, he's joined the attack.
And back it goes.
He's still pushing up. We could, if Hangeland gets a good tackle in here, we win the ball off Taylor. We're in.
Well, I've got some concern for the player.
Here we go. So you go, Berg. Oh, great footwork.
He's on his way now. Here's the chance.
Ron Mike Williamson. Oh, it's a great save. They decided to put a bit more power into it. Does hit the hand of Tim Crewell and bounces off the bar.
6 minutes to go. Well, we could get Berg. Some news on the injury. I think
he should be fit enough to play here again
for
3 days.
The bench, they can see the
Bolasie.
But at the moment,
unlucky.
Not signalling that he wants to come off.
So we're just gonna, at the end, we're just gonna go through a quick final table review of where the teams are, who's top, who's doing well, who's at the bottom. And next episode should be out tomorrow, where we play Newcastle again.
Well, Crystal Palace go up against Newcastle United after this, and why they play.
Marcus Berg could be in here after he's just missed that chance. Berg, he saw Williamson that fake shot. Oh. And he's just put that past the post. Very unlucky there. Jedinak's injured. But that looks like it's going to be it. And there we go. That is it. That's the final whistle of episode number 2. It's another win. We've gone unbeaten so far in our career. A 1-1 draw with Arsenal. Was it 3-0 win against West Ham? And then a 3-1 win against Newcastle United. So, about your performance, they're happy to keep us in, and Marcus Berg's train. And we've had no news on Jedinak, so it looks like it's going well. But what we're going to have to do is go through to find our league this way.
Newcastle United 1.
And there we go. Look where we're sitting. Second place. Played 3. Drew 1-2. Drew 1. Lost none. Absolutely great. Newcastle at the bottom with no points.
West Ham
and Sunderland make 18, 19 and 20. And 1-2-3 is Swansea, Palace and Liverpool. So anyway, our next games for next season and our deadline day, we're not going to be signing anyone. We're going to be playing Newcastle away, Burnley home and then Everton away. So, yeah guys, that is going to be it for episode number 2 of our Crystal Palace career. Hope you're enjoying it as much as me and Bailey are. Make sure you do like, subscribe and comment, and we'll see you tomorrow for episode number 3.